So what we're going to do is we want to work up to be able to factor that. And by like that, I mean, looky there. We've got a 2 in front of the x squared. Don't worry, this is not what you're supposed to get when you multiply those two things.
Okay.
We're working up to it. We're working up to be able to multiply or to factor something where in front of the x squared, we don't have a 1 anymore. We've had a 1 all this time. Okay, so we have a 2 there. So we want to work up to it in order to do that. Let's start kind of from the beginning, right? We know that we multiply two parentheses together. It looks like this. X times x is x squared. X times 4, 4x. 3 times x, 3x. 3 times 4, 12. And it was this kind of pattern that helped us to factor quadratics as well, because since there's a 1 here and a 1 here, very conveniently, 3 times 4 gives us 12, and 3 plus 4 gives us, right, 3x, 4x, x squared plus 7x. 3 plus 4 is 7x, 3 times 4 is 12. So whenever we factored, right, we were always asking ourselves, what multiplies the 12 and adds the 7? So I know how to fill in those blanks. Okay, so remind ourselves of that. Say x squared plus 8x plus 15. No, that's too plus 9x plus 18. 6. X plus 3. X plus 6. Okay. You can quickly ask yourself, does 3 times 6 equal 18? Yeah, we know that that's going to happen. Does 3 plus 6 equal 9? Now we know that that's important because, or that that's a valid question, because when we multiply these together, we're just going to get 6 times x. 3 times x, 3x plus 6x is 9x, right? Easy as pie. And if we had x squared minus 4x minus 45, same question. What times what equals negative 45? We know it's a negative times a positive, so we're running the negative and positive combination. 45, not a lot of combinations. You've got 15 and 3, you've got 9 and 5. So we try 9 and 5, that's 45. Negative 9 plus 5 is negative 4. So we know that we have the correct factorization because negative 9 times 5 is negative 45. Negative 9 plus 5 is negative 4. If we were to multiply it out, it's pretty inevitable that we're going to wind up getting negative 9 times 5 to get negative 45. We're going to wind up getting an x squared. And in the middle, we get 5x minus 9x, which gives us negative 4x. Okay. But when we jump back to that one that I just put up at the beginning. Oh. Let's see. Can I just put x and x to start with? One of these needs to be 2. Why would one of these need to have a 2 in front of it?
Because we have 2x squared.
Yeah, we have x times x would be x squared. We need a 2x squared.
So you get it squared. So it would be x squared.
You put an x squared here?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, those are valid experimentations we could try, but they usually annoy students that we do that because it winds up not working. So I'll just save us all that and say, I'd like to explore it. But it turns out we do want just x to the first and x to the first. Yeah. But in order to get a 2x squared, when I multiply x by x and get x squared, I need a 2 there. If there were a 4 there,
oh, you need a 4.
You need a 4 and a 1, or 2 and a 2. Okay. So now there's like more to think about. We have to think about, what about the two numbers that I have to multiply to give me that guy? Okay. And by the end of this class, I'm going to give you a cool little trick to factor stuff like this. Okay? Call it the AC method. In order to get there, there's a couple things. It's kind of hard, but it's easier in the alternative. Okay? So I'm going to show you the alternative now, and then I'll show you why you want my way rather than this guessing, checking nonsense. All right, so I know that there has to be a 2 there and a 1 there. 2x times x is 2x squared. That's definitely sure that that's got to be what we have there. All right, when I multiply this out, I'm going to wind up getting a number here, a number right here. Agree? Very similar to what we've been doing. Right? So
2
or
10, 4, 7. Or
what numbers do you think maybe go there?
3 and 5.
3 and 5.
Three.
Actually, let's do, what about a 5 here and a 3 there?
That wouldn't work.
Why not?
Because then that would be 6x instead of just 3. Like, because it's a 2x.
Mm-hmm.
So you get 6x, and then 6x plus 5x, that doesn't equal 13.
All right.
You are honest. Okay.
For anybody who is not all the way there yet, let's see why. Well, first of all, why 5 and 3? How come 5 and 3 are?
It equals 15.
Because 5 times 2 is going to be 15. We know that that's going to be part of multiplying this together. Okay, so it seems good. 2x times x is 2x squared. On the end there, 5 times 3 is 15. But again, the middle part is the part that tells us if we've got it right or not. Well, 2x times 3 is 6x. 5 times x is 5x. What's 6x plus 5x? What we're supposed to get?
13.
We're supposed to get 13x. This gives us 11x. Now, in the previous factorizations, switching these didn't make any difference. But notice whatever goes here gets multiplied by a 2x, so it does make a difference this time. We put a 3 there and a 5 there, instead of 5 there and 3 there. We get still 2x squared, 3 times 5 is 15, but now we get 2x times 5 is 10x, 3x,
oh,
2x squared plus 13x plus 15.
Huh.
Okay, now that is a nice one, because 2 only factors one way, 2 times 1, that's it, that's all you can do. 15, it's only going to factor a couple different ways. 1 times 15 is an option, but it wouldn't be my first guess. So 3 times 5, and then you just got to figure out, does the 3 go there, or does 5 go there? And therefore, does the other one go there? Or which order did they go in? Because they clearly make a difference. So if we put all that together into one thought, here's the thought that we have. Either it factors as 2x plus 3 times x plus 5, or it factors as 2x plus 5 times x plus 3. But when we multiply this together, we got 2x squared plus 11x plus 15. So that's not it, and this is it. Not a lot of options. And I guess, yeah, we do have that other option of 2x plus 1 times x plus 15, or 2x plus 15 times x plus 1. But we already know that that's not it. But don't forget about 15 times 1. So we found the factorization, and that's not too bad when this number does not factor a whole lot of different ways, and this number doesn't factor a whole lot of ways. But imagine if both of these numbers factored several different ways, how many more possibilities there would be that we'd have to guess and check? A lot. But before we deal with that, let's just continue with this guessing and checking method for a second, okay? So here's one. Give this a try. 3x squared minus 17x minus 28. It's very similar to what we just did. We know that we're going to wind up with a 3x squared. It's going to be this guy times this guy needs to be 3x squared. This guy times this guy needs to be negative 28. Not a lot of options, but possibility. We're going to look at all the possibilities. We have room for them. Right, and then let's use this one here. Well, I know I'm going to multiply one parentheses by the other, and then part of that is going to be a 3x squared. So that part's not too hard, right? Because I know that the parentheses should look like what? Gotta have a 3x and an x, right?
Yeah, and a b.
Gotta be those x terms multiplied together. Next term and x term multiplied, you get an x squared. To get that 3, you gotta have a 3 from somewhere. There's that one, okay? And it's not like 3 factors some other way. So we know that. We could even write that down in all of them. We know it's got to be that way. At least we know that. Okay, that's kind of a relief. Well, now we look at negative 28 and we ask ourselves, what multiplies in negative 28?
14 and 2.
14 and 2. One of them has to be negative, right? Because we need a negative 28. So it's a positive 14 and negative 2. Is it negative 2 and positive? What is it? And for that matter, does the, like, so let's say we choose negative 2 and positive 14. Does the negative 2 go here and the 14 here? Or does the positive 14 go here and the negative 2 go there? Or
yeah, that's where I got stuck.
Does the negative 14 go here and a positive 2 go here? Or does
the first one.
Positive 2 go here, and a negative 14 go there. Just from the one factorization, 14 times 2, and needing one of them to be negative, we have four possibilities. That's just assuming 14 and 2 are the right combination. Because how else can we multiply to 28?
Boom.
I think
four
it's 4
and
7.
4 and 7.
Okay,
so we have to do all that again for 4 and 7.
No, we don't.
Alright, let's look at all those possibilities.
Yes, please.
3x. We at least have 3x and x, right? 3x was 7 and 4, so maybe it's plus 7 and minus 4. But then again, maybe it's minus 7 and x plus 4.
Okay,
and again, maybe it's 3x minus 4 times x plus 7. But then yet again, maybe it's 3x. What have we not had? Plus 4? Plus 4 and minus 7. Okay. Every one of these 8 combinations has a different product. Every one of them comes out to be a different product. Okay. And at most, this is assuming like we've got all the possibilities, at most, only one of them is correct. So, worst case is we try it once, twice, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times, none of them comes out right, and only the 8th time it works. Okay? Even worse than that is we made a mistake somewhere, none of them worked. Or it's just impossible. Or it's impossible. Maybe it's not even factorable. Or there's even more possibilities. You're gonna get the idea, I won't write them all down. What if the factorization of 28 is 28 times 1? So there's four more, right? Positive 28, negative 1, negative 28, positive 1, positive 1, negative 28. All those different possibilities.
Yeah, it's just impossible.
So all that, including the 1 times 28 factorization for 28, amounts to 12 different possibilities, each of which we have to try until we have the right one. Now we can be a little smarter about it. We can say to ourselves, well, I'm not gonna try the 1 times 28 approach right away. Because I don't think that's right. I don't think that's gonna work. My instinct tells me it's either gonna be 14 times 2 or 7 times 4. So I'll start with those. Let's say I were to try this one. Let's try it out. 3x times x is 3x squared. Negative 2 times 14 at the end there is negative 28. In the middle we get 3x times 14 is 42x. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. So this gives us 3x squared plus 40x minus 28.
Nope.
So that's not it. But this helps me out if I look over here. This one's exactly the same, except for the signs of 2 and 14 have been swapped.
Right.
Okay. So where this was 42x minus 2x, this would be 2x minus 42x. So I come up with a negative 40x instead of a positive 40x, but that's still wrong. But at least I know that switching the signs is not going to help. Okay. Well, now I'm stuck trying this one. So 3x times x is 3x squared. 14 times negative 2 is negative 28. 3x times negative 2 is negative 6x. 14 times x is 14x. But that's 3x squared plus 8x minus 28. That's not going to work. This one, swapping the positive and negative signs, is just going to give me 3x squared minus 8x minus 28. I know that that one's not going to work, at least. Okay. We try this one, 3x squared minus 12x plus 7x minus 28. Negative 12x plus 7x is negative 5x. That's not going to work. Swapping the signs, just swapping the signs is not going to work either. That would just give me 3x squared plus 5x minus 28. All right, we're getting close. Right? 3x minus 4 times x plus 7, 3x squared. 3x times 7 is 21x. Negative 4 times x is negative 4x. Negative 4 times 7 is negative 28. 3x squared, 21x minus 4x, positive 17x.
So it's just the swap one.
So it's what? The swap one, yeah. So that's not it, but the swap one we know will be, because it's just going to give us 3x squared
so
minus 17x.
And in order for it to work, it has to be equal with the 3x squared minus 17x minus 28.
Like they have to be exactly the same?
Yes.
Yeah. Like that's how we check it.
No, I think it can't have a 4x. Yeah, 4x.
Well, it will work.
It'll be exactly the same with 4x in there. Totally.
We got 3x squared minus 21x plus 4x minus 28, and the 4x minus 21x is negative 7x. Okay? Well, that example was bad enough, I think.
I hated it.
We didn't have to do it.
If we had to include these other pot, like if this hadn't worked, here's the thing that goes through your mind. This hadn't worked.
It's impossible.
Now we're thinking, it's impossible. Here's one option. It's impossible. Or, well, now I have to try 1 times 28. Instead of 7 times 4 or 2 times 14, I've got to try 1 times 28. So that's 4 more possibilities. If I try that and something doesn't work, either it's impossible or is it
17.
Is it believable that maybe in 12 different attempts of multiplying two parentheses together, I made mistakes in there.
It could have been also maybe half.
But so would you constantly be doing this if you wanted to if you were to check it? Would you constantly be doing this until you found the common factor that would equal up to it?
Until you multiplied it out and it came out to be exactly right, 3x squared minus 17x minus 28.
Okay, so you can do it like 100 times and if it's wrong, then you're still going.
You can do it 100 times, yeah. And if there's more possibilities, you're trying those out. The problem with it is there's so much work and it takes so long. That's one thing. You have to not make any mistakes, because if you make a mistake, it's not going to work out.
No.
You can even make a mistake and it does equal what you're trying to get, but you did something wrong and you got the right answer, but the wrong way.
Possibly 3 times.
Okay. So there's just so much that I don't like about that approach. It can do it. It'll get you there, eventually, if you don't make any mistakes. And it's factorable. That's another valid point. Is it factorable at all? This one is. It's 3x plus 4 times x minus 7.
So you could be sitting there for 6 hours starting to do this, and then like the next hour, it's not factorable. So
it's conceivable. You just tried all the possibilities, and none of them work, so it's impossible. Or you made a mistake somewhere in all those different 6 hours of multiplying things together.
Hey, you didn't spend another 6 hours.
So that's why I'm going to, what hopefully I've done successfully is sell you on a better way. Okay, this other way, it's like kind of weird, right? But it's perfectly mathematically sound, and it'll work every time. And it'll tell you that it's factorable, it's not factorable. Okay, if this method doesn't work, right? There's a telltale sign that's like, it's not factorable, you can't do.
Yeah, let me ask you, is there an easier way to do this?
This? Yes, that's what we're about to look at.
Oh, sweet.
Is there another question? Okay, let's start with an easy one. So the numbers are fairly small. So we'll start with that first one that we had at the beginning, 2x squared. That's 13x
plus 15.
Plus 15. Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll use this example. The numbers are pretty small. It's not gonna be, you're really gonna wanna write this down. So you're sitting in an unorthodox place, make sure you're writing this down. Okay, so this approach will sound familiar. It's similar. Like you kind of ask yourself the same questions as when you factor something like this, right? What multiplies the 18 and adds to 9? Right? It's going to sound a lot like that. But here's how it goes. First of all, first thing you're always going to do, well, even before what I was about to say, always make sure that you factor out anything. All have in common if there's anything they all have. So if they all have a 2 in common, make sure you take 2 out, otherwise it's unnecessarily difficult. If they all have a 3 in common, take out the 3. If they all have an x in common, take out the x. Or take out anything they all have in common first. That's just kind of like rule number 0. It comes even before rule number 1 of factoring. Okay, so here I'm going to draw something to help me organize my. This x is not this x, just a big cross to help me put stuff in place. So the first thing is, we're going to take a multiplied by c. What are a and c? Let me tell you. When you have a quadratic written in order of descending powers of x, which this is, right? X squared, that's the highest power, comes first. X to the first, that's the next highest, and then no x's. That comes last. Write it like that. When it's written like that, we always call that first thing a, ax squared. A is the number that's multiplied by x squared, plus bx plus c. Gotta make sure you write it in order of descending power, though. If it's not written that way, then that doesn't really work. It's not always just the first number that you see. A is first as long as you write it. So what's A in this one?
2.
A is 2. What's C?
15.
So first thing, A times C, 2 times 15 is 30.
Wait, how do you know it's 2 and 15?
Well, the first part, this is why I call it the AC method, because the first thing we're going to do is multiply A by C. A.
You guys are talking about. That's how you find your point of it out.
Yeah, that 2 right there, that's A, 15 is C, 2 times 15.
Okay.
All right. Down here,
no.
B. What's B?
13.
All right. So I write my A times C there, or my 13 there, that's B. So here's how it sounds similar. What number? What two numbers multiply to 30 but add to 13?
3. Oh, sorry.
2 and 15. Wait.
2 and 15 add
negative
30,
2 and 15.
They subtract.
Negative 2.
But they need to multiply to positive 30.
God. 3 and 10.
3 and 10.
Oh, it juked me out.
And 10.
Oh,
thanks.
Alright, so that's the first thing we do. To figure out 3 and 10. And then we'll multiply to 30 and add to 13. All right, here's what we do next. We're going to take the 10 and the 3. Since they add together to 13, I'm going to separate the 13x. Do 10x plus 3x. Actually, let's write it in the order that it appears up there. 3x plus 10x. It won't matter. You can do it either way you want. But since we have 3 and 10, I'll write 3 and then 10. to know for the future, it will still work if you do 10x plus 3x instead of 3x plus 10x. Just keep it consistent. All right, so then the rest of it, of course, is what the rest of it is. So notice 2x squared plus 3x plus 10x plus 15. If I add the 3x and the 10x, I get 3x, or 13x. So it's all the same. It's equal to what it started as. You keep adding. Okay. So not a lot has been done. We kind of learned some things along the way that we needed to know, like this is A and this is C. But if you write it in descending order of powers, you just take this guy A times C, that's 30, we put 13 there, we'll multiply to 30 and add to 13. So far, that's all we've done. But now I'm going to look at this sum of four things as two groups of two. This group here and that group there. I'm not going to put parentheses around it because that could be confusing and misleading. So I'm just looking at it as this group, these two things, and these two things. Okay. So I'm going to kind of do the same kind of thing to both of these groups, but they're going to kind of be separate. So what I'm going to do with each of these groups is figure out what do these two have in common and factor that out. What do these two have in common and factor that out? What do these two have in common?
They both have the same digit number.
Well, like what factor do they have? Like what can I undistribute?
Undistribute the x.
What?
Yes.
The x, right? They don't have any number factors in common. They do have an x factor in common. X times, okay, 2x plus 3. If I distributed the x, I'd get 2x squared plus 3x. What do these two have in common? We'll take out a positive 5. Okay. Now, what I want you to notice is that this, the stuff that's in this green circle, it should be equal to whatever I write next. I'm adding on this group. I'm going to add on a 5 times. If I factor out a 5 from there, I get 2x. Factor out a 5 from there, I get 3. So by now, there's two times we can tell whether or not this is even possible, whether or not it's factorable. If you couldn't have done this part, it's not factorable. If you cannot multiply A times C and then write B here, and find two numbers that multiply to 30 and add to 13, if it's not possible, then it can't be factored. And so you know you're done way before you would have with the guess and check method.
So it'd be kind of like,
if this was 5?
Yeah.
Yeah, if that were 5, then that's not going to be factorable. You're not going to be able to factor it. Okay. At this point, you can tell you've done everything correctly so far if this parentheses, 2x plus 3, is exactly the same as this parentheses, 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3, 2x plus 3. Those have to be identical, otherwise, we cannot continue. So what we do next, one last thing, just one last thing, and then we're done.
Alright.
The thing that we're going to do now, in this step, is very similar to what we did in each of the green circles. We're just looking for what they have in common. In this group, they had an x in common, we factored out an x. In this group, they had a 5 in common, we factored out a 5. If I were to distribute the 5 and distribute the x, it would simplify right back down to how we started. So we know that it's all the same. It's all equal. Now we're going to look at the whole thing. And since we've done everything correctly so far, we know that we can factor something out here. The thing we can factor out is 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3.
Well, look, I made this one. What? I thought you were wrong.
So, now this next part, it's for very few people, it just feels like, oh, yeah, of course. I see what you're doing. It takes several times for most people to say, oh, I saw. And now I see what you're doing. okay? But to give ourselves the best chance, let me just point this out. Look what the difference, like, look what happened between this green circle and this guy right here.
You subtracted it.
We didn't subtract the x, we factored it out in x. Yeah, so I took out the x that if I multiplied it back in, if I distributed it back in, there you go, that's what I get, right? Same thing here. Took out the 5, if I distributed it back in, I just get 10x plus 15 again. We're doing the same thing here to the entire black rectangled thing. But this time, instead of having an x in common like this, or a 5 in common like this, they both have 2x plus 3, like an entire parentheses, in common. So I'm going to factor out 2x plus 3. I factored out 2x plus 3 from this term right here, leaving me with x. I factored out 2x plus 3 from this term, leaving me with a 5. And it's done. It's factored. 2x plus 3 times x plus 5.
When? So you just add them?
Nope. So this is the thing. If you're just seeing like the magic moving to the left of this thing, and then just the adding together of those two things, you're not quite seeing it. But that's a really common thing. Now, if I write that parentheses right there, and I write that thing plus that thing in the other parentheses, it'll be right every time.
So basically just cross out 2x plus 3.
No, not basically side. Cross out the 2x plus 3. No. Nope.
Okay.
Nope. Not basically that. I am telling you, if you write what's in this parentheses here, and that thing plus that thing, you get that. But I'm not about saying things that aren't true. So not basically cross that out. Even though that's what most people do in their brains, they just say like, okay, I'll write that one there, that one, I don't know what happened to it, it just disappeared, and then just add an x plus 5.
Do you add the 2 from the x to the 3?
Add the 2
from the x to the 3, and that gives 5.
Nope.
Are you telling me 2 just add the x over 5? That's it?
Say again.
Are you telling me 2 just add the x to the 5 and take out the 2 plus 3?
I'm not telling you to do that, I am just telling you that if we did this 5 times in a row, it would maybe look like to some that this thing just floats over here, this thing disappears, this is not at all what's happening, but this is how it looks to some. This thing comes over here, this thing disappears, and this thing plus this thing goes in the other parentheses. Well, it's not going to be wrong. It is going to be the correct factored form of this. If you did that, you get it right. And, you know, there's no way I could know any different that you're either doing it correctly or thinking of it incorrectly, and you'll still get the answer right. That's not what's going on here.
But what actually happened?
Okay, so what actually happened? Love that question. Okay. Let me just say real quickly, just like we factored out an x from here and there, right? Factored out an x from this guy and from this guy. It came outside the parentheses. We put the parentheses here. X times 2x would give us 2x squared. X times 3 would give us 3x. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Factor out x. Same thing over here, just another example of the same kind of thing. Factor out of 5. Factor out of 5, inside the parentheses, we're left with 2x plus 3. Exact same thing happened here. It's just that we didn't factor out a simple x or a simple 5. What we factored out was this parentheses right here, and this parentheses right here. They both had a common factor. The factor was 2x plus 3, that whole parentheses. Just like the common factor here was x, and the common factor here was 5, the common factor here is 2x plus 3. So just as x came outside the parentheses, and this became x times 2x plus 3, 2x plus 3 comes outside the parentheses, and we're left with x plus 5. Let's try this. Let's put a parentheses around the whole thing. Okay. So imagine like there's the inside of the parentheses. And from this guy and from this guy on the right, we factor out 2x plus 3 to the outside of the parentheses. And what's left is x plus 5.
Yeah.
Let's look at it another way. Let's just reverse this whole thing. Okay? In the first the first time that we multiply two parentheses like this, this is the whole, this is like the payoff, is this method of factorization. Okay? And that's what I call double distribution. Double distribution. Remember double distribution? We distribute and we distribute again. Okay? We kind of let that fade away because there's a faster way to do it, but it's still technically, you know, the correct way. Okay? So let's do double distribution. When I do the first distribution, this is going to look exactly like that. So remember, for double distribution, we're going to distribute this to the x and this to the 5. Is that familiar?
Yeah.
I hope so, because we did it quite a few times. That was quiz on it. Yeah, another quest with that exact thing on it, double distribution. So let's double distribute. Actually, let's just distribute the first time. Distribute the 2x plus 3 to the x. 2x plus 3 times x, that's x times 2x plus 3. See that? We're distributing the 2x plus 3, just like we would distribute anything. If there were a 7 there, if this were 7 instead, it would become 7x plus 35, right? It would be 7x plus 35. But it's not a 7, it's 2x plus 3. It's this entire thing, this entire parenthesis. So I distribute the 2x plus 3 to the x, and I distribute the 2x three plus to the 5, I get 5 times 2x plus 3. See how the whole parentheses gets distributed to, boom, the x and the 5, and that's the result. X times 2x plus 3 and 5 times 2x plus 3, because they both got that whole parentheses distributed to them. Well, look at this, and look at this guy in orange. Exactly the same. So all we did from orange, this orange step to this black step is we undid this. We took that factor of 2x plus 3 out, right, out of the parentheses, and what's left inside is x plus 5. It's this thing, sometimes it can be like, you ever see that optical illusion of that, this is silhouette of that dancer going in circles.
Seen the spiral one.
We've all seen the spiral. Well, it's just it's a silhouette of a dancer. She's like up on one toe, she's got one foot out like this, and she's just spinning around in circles. But because it's a silhouette, you don't see like this leg come in front of this. So you don't know if really like this leg's in front or if it's behind, right? So it looks like to some people that she's spinning this way, and to others that she's spinning this way.
Can I see it?
Maybe we have time at the end, I can show you what I'm talking about. But okay. Yeah, it's an optical illusion. It's like any optical illusion where some people see it one way, some people see it the other. Is it a duck or is it a rabbit? Some people see a duck, some people see a rabbit. Is it an old man or an old woman or a young woman? Some people see the old woman, some people see the young woman. Kind of like this, right? And eventually, and I'm hoping after we do a few of these, as it kind of snaps in place, and you see, oh, I'm not just moving stuff around, I'm actually factoring out 2x plus 3 from this guy and this guy. They both are losing that factor of 2x plus 3. It's coming out here, right? And what's left is x plus 5. And if I were to distribute the 2x plus 3 back in, what do we get? 2x plus 3 times x. Plus 5 times 2x plus 3. I did exactly what the step before it looked like. Whew, okay. Let's do another example. Okay. That was, you know, the first one's always tough. It's the first time you've seen it. What's going on? Let's try it again. Let's try that. 5x squared. 13x minus 6. So it's already written in order. X squared comes first, x comes next, just the number term comes third. And so, of course, this is a x squared plus b times x plus c. So in this case, c to the negative 6 came all. A, B, and C. So again, this is why they call it the AC method. First thing is to multiply A by C. A is 5. C is what?
6.
It's negative,
negative 6.
So 5 times negative 6. Hold out on me. 5 times negative 6.
31.
Negative 30.
Negative 30.
Oh, God.
Negative 30. Alright, so that's the AC part. AC. Down here goes
B.
Right? Always AC is B. Like, we could make a sticker out of this, of just this cross, AC here, B there, always the same. A times C there, B there. Okay? You can make up these stickers, you can just slap it on every homework problem, every test question. That part would always be the same. So B is 13. And again, we ask ourselves the same question. What multiplies negative 30 and adds to positive 30? Multiplies to negative 30, adds to positive 13.
Oh, this is similar.
Very similar.
Adds to it?
3.
Yeah, 10. Multiplies to this, adds to this.
Negative 3 and then 10.
Negative 3 and 10?
Or negative 10 and 3.
Whichever.
Negative 10 and positive 3?
I don't know.
Nah, let's go. Multiply to a negative, right? Multiply to a negative. So one of them has to be positive, one of them has to be negative.
Yeah, negative 3.
Negative 3 positive 10?
Wait, no, hold on.
That does multiply to negative 30, but what does that add to?
Not 13. Negative.
Adds
not
to
13.
7.
Oh.
Negative 3 plus 10 is 7.
So 10?
10 and negative 3? Still, 10 times negative 3 is negative 30, but 10 minus 3 is 7.
I was about to say that.
Well, I think 10 and 3 is going to present the same problem every time. Negative 10 times 3 is negative 30. Negative 10 plus 3 is now negative 7. But we need a positive 13 here. We know it's positive and negative.
No.
Because it multiplies to negative 30. Multiplies to negative 30 adds to positive 13. Try pretty much every combination of 10 and 3, with one of them being negative.
It's not working.
There's other ways to multiply to 30, right?
5 and 6.
No.
5 and 6, but they don't add to 13. One of them has to be negative.
2 times 3. I mean, 2 times, sorry. 2 times 15.
Negative 15 and 2. Negative 15?
9.
Yeah, whatever. Just throw them. Okay.
Positive 2, negative 15. What's 2 times negative 15? What's 2 minus 15? What's 2 minus 15? Negative 13.
9 and 4.
So it's negative 2 and positive 15? Or 9?
Positive 15, negative 2. 15 times negative 2 is negative 30. And 15 minus 2 is positive 13.
9 and 4 work though.
Well, 9 times 4 is not 30.
Oh. I just did like 13.
36. And on top of that, not again, they have to multiply to negative 30. One of them has to be negative. The other one has to be positive. So 9 and 4 also wouldn't add to 13 if one of them is negative. You either get positive or negative 5, depending on which one is negative. So looking back in that last example, you know, what did we do with that 15 and that negative 2? What came next? It's really, this is why it's important that it add to 13. What did we do next? Let's look at your previous example, what we did when we found those two numbers. What did we do?
We went to 2.
So that was from, we've got 3 and 10. That's where we went to 2x squared plus 3x plus 10x, right? So what do we do here?
You figure out the 13.
Hold on. You make 13 into, say,
15 negative 2.
15x minus 2x. Okay, 5x squared plus 15x minus 2x. 15x minus 2x is 13x. Lots of different ways to add two x terms together to get 13, but it's really important that these two numbers also multiply to the same thing that these two multiply to. That's really important. So these two numbers multiply to the same thing that these two multiply. So 5 times negative 6 is negative 30, 15 times negative 2 is negative 30. And that's important because, well, all the factors of 5 and 6 make up these two numbers as well, and we're going to look for as common factors. So we found it. We found the 15x minus 2x is 13x, and so here we go again. This group,
5.
And this group. This group has what?
There's 5.
And
that group has an x. So you pick up an
x. So a 5 and an x. So these two factor out a 5 and an x. Leaves us with x, 5x times x is 5x squared, plus 3. 5x times 3 is 15x. These two?
1.
There's more than a 1 or
negative.
Negative.
You can take
so here's a tip. If this first guy here turns out to be negative, always factor out a negative. Whatever the number is, even if it's a 1, factor a negative. Factor out a negative. So that this first guy inside the parentheses will be positive, like this one is. Factor out a negative. Is that it though? Negative 1?
Negative 2.
Negative 2. They both have a negative 2 in common. Alright, factoring out a negative 2. Factoring out a negative 2. Factor negative 2 from there, we just get x. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. What would be here? Negative 2 times this is negative 6.
Plus 3.
Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. What do you see in the parentheses? X plus 3 and x plus 3 are identical. This part tells us early on whether or not it's factorable. If we weren't able to find two numbers that multiply negative 3 and negative 13, we would just stop. Not factorable. But we found it. Okay, so we found it. We worked our way down to here. And this tells us that we should continue, because x plus 3 and x plus 3 are identical. If we were able to find this, but these didn't come out identical, we made a mistake. We did something wrong. We need to go back. Do not try and move forward without these two being exactly the same. Because the thing we're doing next would not make any sense if those two weren't the same. So again, one more thing, and it's over. It's factored. It's done. Both of these terms, this one here and this one here, both have something in common. They don't have a 5 in common. They don't have a 2 in common. They don't have an x in common. They have x plus 3 and x plus 3 in common. They both have an x plus 3. So, like if you thought of this as, kind of like if you thought of this as inside parentheses, and the 5x came outside the parentheses. Okay? Same thing here. These are like inside the parentheses. We're going to divide this by x plus 3, divide this by x plus 3, bring that factor of x plus 3 outside of the parentheses, undistributed. That x plus 3 parentheses. Okay. So out comes the x plus 3 for both of those. So here it is, x plus 3 outside the parentheses times whatever's left inside, which is 5x minus 2. And again, if I were to take that x plus 3 and do the first part of double distribution, I just take x plus 3 times 5x. X plus 3. Take the x plus 3, distribute it to the negative 2. Negative 2 times x plus 3. In fact, x plus 3 times 5x minus 2.
Yeah,
huh?
I like that one.
It's better than the guessing and going all over the place and spending 6 hours and hoping you didn't make a mistake. Even in this, if you make a mistake, there's not that much involved. So just go back a few steps and figure out what you did wrong. So it's weird. I mean, this whole, especially this last step, is a weird one. people. It's hard to sell them on it. Hopefully you're sold on doing it this way.
Yeah, I didn't really do. They have in common 5x, and then they also have in common -2. Like, where do they?
Only these two have a 5x in common. And that's why we only factored a 5x. Like, we ignored this part for a second, just factored a 5x. Then we ignored this and factored a -2 from those two.
Yeah, and then it equals 6. -2 plus
right.
equals 6.
So it's like, in no way does this have anything to do with that.
Right.
Just
okay, that's where I got confused. Because right. I said they both have -2. It's like, that one doesn't have -2.
Right.
And,
yeah, by both. Yeah, we're talking about those.
Okay. Right, that makes sense now. Okay, so.
I would say officially this method is called factoring by grouping. Okay. It's called factoring by grouping because I split it into two groups and I approach the factorization with those two groups. Factoring by grouping. We'll get some more factoring by grouping later as we factor more complicated polynomials. But for now, when we're factoring quadratics, that's it. That's the factoring by grouping that we use. Okay. So now we need another one, and you take it from there. See if we can work it all the way through. Soto. We did that one, I think we did that one.
I think we've only done two.
Then, yeah, let's do 3x squared plus 7x plus 2. Oh, we did that one, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
So,
it's right there. Okay, yeah. I thought so. Okay, so here's the one that we'll actually do. 6x squared plus 7x minus 24. So we got two examples of what I like to call the AC method. Follow along with those. See if you can duplicate it for this problem by yourself.
No, I
got it in order.
I got this.
And first of all, 6 times negative 24 is negative 144. So like we're all there. We need to add it to 7. Well, it's not going to be 12. It's got to multiply to a negative and add to a positive, right? So we got to have a positive and a negative. Positive times negative is the only way to get a negative. This number clearly has to be bigger, right? The magnitude of this number has to be bigger than the magnitude of that number because after I have a positive, positive 7. So it's not going to be 12 and negative 12 because that would add to 0. It's not going to be 24 and 6. Right? That was already there and that doesn't combine to 7.
Yeah, but that won't work for 7. There are several different possibilities.
No.
26 and 6, I think it was. 26 times 6 equals... Wait, no, 26 and 5. But that won't work.
5?
Yeah, I know.
I don't think 26 and 5. This is not a multiple of 5.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait, what was it? 25 times...
It's not going to be 25. 5 is a factor of 25, and this definitely doesn't have a factor of 5 in it.
So that's 24 and 6. 24
and
6?
Mm-hmm. 4 and 6, but they don't.
Yeah, I know, they don't equal
7. There's so many different possibilities, right? So let me help you figure this out. Like 144, let's figure out all the different ways we can factor rather than just kind of like randomly stabbing at it. So 144, 12 and 12, right? 12 times 12 is 144, just factoring into its prime factors. 3 times 4, right, 2 times 2, so 3 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 2 times 2, that's 144.
Right.
And so I can put these together however I like. I can put this 3, this 2, and this 3 together. And then this 2 and this 2, and then be one way. So this would be 6 times 6 36 times 4. Well, even though 36 times 4 is 144, like 36 minus 4 is not 7. That's not going to be it. Okay, so 36 is a little too big. Let's go a little smaller than that. Let's try just like 3 and 3 and 2. 3 times 3 times 2. 9 times 2, that's 18. And this is 8. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So 18 times 8 is 144, but 18 minus 8 is 10, not 7. Okay. Let's try just 3 times 3 and 16 and 9. How about 16 and 9?
Nope.
If I had a 16 there,
a 16 times 9
and a negative 9.
16 times 9.
Then that's what we want.
Yeah.
We do want that. And then 16 minus 9, is that 7?
Yeah.
I found it. It takes a little while. But think about, like, for all of the different combinations there were to get negative 144 to add to 7.
Wait a minute. I said that. I said 16 and 9. I said I found, I got 16 and 9, and I just named all the ones that I had off.
Oh.
I said, like, 24 and...
So you said a lot?
Yeah, I know. I was like, blah, 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 blah.
It might seem like, oh, well, this way takes forever, too. But for all of the different combinations there were for 144, the combinations for the two parentheses, first of all, that we get a 6 could be a 2x times a 3x. It could be a 1x times a 6x. This 24 factors a bunch of different ways. 1 times 24, 2 times 12, 3 times 8, 4 times 6. Right? So there's four different ways that it factors. With two different ways that this factors. In fact, this has to be a negative, so we need a positive and a negative. In fact, it's just like there's a ton more combinations. Even if the number of combinations was the same, checking this one is way faster than checking to see if the combination you're guessing at works here. Because here you have to multiply everything together if you're just guessing and checking. Here you just have to see if that adds to 7. That's it. Right? You need to multiply to negative 144 and add to 7.
Okay.
That is still guessing and checking a bit, but the checking is faster, and it's less prone to mistakes as well.
Now we have to address the problem.
Remind you to always, first thing, always make sure that if there's anything that they all have in common, all terms have in common, that you factor it out. Okay. So before you start factoring, say, 2x squared plus 6x minus 8, you factor out a what?
A 2.
A 2. So we have 2 times x squared plus 3x minus 4. Okay. That's important. That actually would factor. So we could just create kind of a blind spot in your mind for this 2 because it's already factored out. It's not necessary to consider when factoring the rest of it. Right? So the rest of it would just factor as normal. So you just kind of blur this and just kind of let it fade into the background because we're not even considering it as we factor the rest. Then we just factor this as normal. Right? What multiplies to a negative 4 and adds to 3? How about a positive 4 and a negative 1? So it's factored. So factor out that 2 first, then factor as normal, ignoring the 2 except for to bring it along each step afterward. And if there were a negative in front of all this, say negative x squared minus 3x plus 4, with this negative in front, there's a negative in front, no matter what. Just always factor out a negative. Always. Negative 1 times x squared plus 3x minus 4. Then factor this guy. So always factor out what they have in common. Now, for the exciting conclusion of this problem, 6x squared plus 16x minus 9x, that was the whole reason we did this 16 and negative 9 room rule. And again, if I put minus 9x and plus 16x, still going to work out. It'll look different than my friend who did 16x minus 9x, but at the end it'll come out the same. So we look at these two, right? This group, that's why it's called factoring by grouping. What do they have in common? What do these two guys have in common? What?
Two. I mean, sorry, two.
Just
two.
X. 2x. Leaving us with 2x times 3x is 6x squared. 2x times 8 is 16x. Then we look at this group. This group. What does this group have in common? What do these two have in common? What?
3.
And since this is negative in front, I'll back that up. Negative 3. Negative 3. Negative 3 times 3x is negative 9x. Negative 3 times positive 8 is negative 24. We know that it's factorable because we were able to find the 16 and negative 9. We know we've done everything right so far because these both have a 3x plus 8. And the last part is to factor out that 3x plus 8, right, to the outside of the parentheses. 3x plus 8 times 2x minus 3. 3x plus 8 times 2x minus 3. We factored it. We did it. And remember, maybe the third reminder today, if the first step of all this is to multiply 6 times negative 24, 8 times c, if that's the first step, then step 0 before that, check and make sure that you can if there's anything to factor out of all of the terms. You can factor out a 2, factor that out. Factor out a negative, factor out the negative.